chance to look at it.
The Everyone updates happy? Were sent, and then the new ones are in front of you.
Approve as amended.
Okay. Motion to approve the amended minutes.
I'll approve. Make a motion.
And second?
I tried to send in to try to correct mine. Mine still needs to be corrected from last minute. I sent an email, and I thought that she corrected it, but it's not changed in here.
Okay, so then we cannot then approve tonight's minutes.
You can approve it with changes.
Yeah, just okay with pending Natalie's changes. Pending changes already noted, and the secretary has those changes, Natalie. Then
She should. I can email them to her again, but okay. I thought she did.
Email them to me as well.
Yeah, that's my
all right. Approval of the amended minutes, September 24, 2015, from Natalie. Motion to approve by Ann. Second by
Ethel.
Ethel. All those in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Pass. Public comment for non-agenda items. Anyone want to make public comment? Non-agenda items. Nope. Anyone? Okay, moving on. And we got discussion items. Giza has wanted to discuss about some building project or something, correct? Kevin, who's gonna speak? George's. George, what's your last name, please? Fulmer, if you will. George, welcome to the CRC.
I'm sorry, can you talk into the microphone so the people on TV can hear you?
No, see if the handheld works then.
On the side.
Hello. Okay.
There you go.
Now we're cooking.
All right, so you want to build a building the current building.
Yeah, west of the existing building, yep. We've had a storage shed over here, the mini storage, for quite a few years, and recently moved our stuff out. We want to build a building for our own use there. With our Island Fest tournament, we're getting bigger and bigger, and we need a place. We'd like to have a concession going for that tournament to accommodate all of our kids and parents and visitors and all such. So that's what our plan is. Do I put this here, or you just kind of want to see this?
Yeah, you can put it there. Great.
Okay, this is kind of an idea. This is kind of what we want. It might not be exactly like that, but it's about a 24 by 32 pole barn kind of looking building.
Serve as like a makeshift shelter.
Just scoot the paper down a little bit, please. There you go.
There you go.
And what's your name?
My name is Steve Molnar, M-O-L-N-A-R.
And you're with Giza also too, Steve? Okay.
So what's most important to us on the thing is having restroom, bathroom facilities on this, water and power and sewer. So that's, I don't know how complicated that could be. I don't know where the water and sewer facilities are, how close they're located to the site. We haven't looked at site drawings yet. We talked to Brandy about that briefly,
Duker? Dale Riem?
Well, no, I did talk to you briefly about it. Brian? Yeah, that's right. No, it was Brandy. So anyhow.
They talked to the building department and then
Michael. Yeah, I talked to Lori in the building department and then Brandy briefly. But Lori told me to go see Brandy, and Brandy, here we are. So she said to bring it to you guys. So we would like to put this building up, and it's self-funded. We have money. Right now, currently grading a field to the west of the driveway, the northwest corner of the property, to make another soccer field in there and to come, again, our Island Fest tournament.
But this building was the exact thing that you had, Tom, too? So what's the pad size in this?
We're not going to pour a pad, per se.
Yeah, 24 by 32.
24 by 32.
Roughly.
All right, so we're talking about going west of that. So right there, that's our handicap parking where we have.
I actually think that the Michigan Building Code is going to require you to build a pad. You may even have to put footings in. I'm assuming
we
you're
would.
Going to pull a
we
building
most definitely
permit
would.
For it.
Right? I think so too, right? Some rat wall or
something. Oh, absolutely.
On the island, yeah.
Yeah, we would definitely have a rat wall footing, a foundation thing for sure.
Okay. Now, sorry. You said something about you're already building. Sorry. Thank you. You said you're already building a field over there?
We're dozing on the west side of the road right now.
Where the.
And northwest corner.
Now, what happened to moving north? I thought we gave you guys permission to go north into the tree line. And not to start anything with the fields, the baseball fields is.
Well, I guess that's where the confusion lies. That's probably correct. But I think there was some misunderstanding. We went to the, we didn't want to cut the trees down. So we went west where it was just all grass.
But the five-year plan calls for the baseball fields to be there. And I think the last gentleman that was up here asking us if they could do that, we said the baseball fields were going in. I don't remember if
it wasn't either one of us.
Okay.
We understand that, but we really need a field. And if okay. baseball field
but
goes
here's
there,
the other thing, though, too.
So be it.
Did anybody give you permission to build the fields over yet?
Well, I guess we thought we had permission.
From? And I don't mean, I don't want to sound rude, but.
Sure.
You know, you come in here asking for a building, which is fine, but you're already building a field. So I guess I'm confused.
Well.
I think there. Asked in recent, and I think the.
For the record, state your name, Kevin, please.
Kevin Naso, NASO. I think there was some confusion as what we're going to, where to be able to put it. We're under the impression that that was rec land. We needed a field really quick. We understood that's potentially going to be for baseball. So if baseball comes through in a couple years or a year and they need to put their fields there, we're going to adhere to it. We need something for the Island Fest, and our Island Fest tournament is going to grow from 60 to about 120 teams. It's only going to bring more folks to the island for the Island Fest.
No, I understand all that. But I guess my concern, too, is the rec department doesn't really own that property. Brandy, correct me if I'm wrong here, but the Commerce Park owns that. We lease it from the rec department, from them, correct?
It's our property, but we don't have full rights to it because the airport can take over it whenever they
correct.
Want.
So any new construction, I would think, would have to go through the airport before it even
not
came.
Not if it's just rec property. It's, we
is it?
Can,
okay.
We
all
do
right,
that.
All right. Well,
that's
I get,
why we gave permission to go north into the shrub line.
And
to
I think
spend it that way.
And I think the reason we didn't go into the shrub line is because we didn't want to take trees down. We didn't want to step on people's boundaries and take trees out. And that's why we went that way. I mean,
well, the only thing we got going now here is they're building that field there. We're going to have field, parking, field. What are you guys going to do for safety? What's your plan for safety to have a parking lot between two fields? Kids running back and forth.
We're going to fence it off.
Well, I think we need to see a plan before we can say, hey, go ahead and do what you're doing already.
Sure.
I mean, I'm going to sound like a you know what, but I mean, I think it's kind of disrespectful. You come up here, ask to build a building where you already built a field, and ask to build the field. You know, and that's just my personal opinion. I don't know how the rest of the people feel, but I mean,
no,
it's kind of.
I guess we thought we were good to go on the field. So it's obviously a misunderstanding on our part, but we thought we had the blessing already. So sorry for that. I didn't mean to step on anyone's toes, but we kind of thought we were clear on it. Obviously not. So we'll give you a plan of what we want to do, where we want to, how we want to close it off and keep it safe. Absolutely.
I would suggest you stop building the field until we approve it then.
Okay.
Just in case there is an issue with it. I'd hate to see all that. I'm sure you guys are getting volunteers, and the dirt's probably being donated and whatnot.
For ourselves.
Okay, well, it makes it even worse then, because obviously you don't want to spend that money, and then for some reason, God forbid, it doesn't get approved, and you wasted all that money and time. And I used to be in the Giza board, and, money's time, volunteers valuable. So I would just, let's get something in front of us, let us, look at it, approve it, and then you guys can, if we're all on the same page, I don't see a problem with it.
Well, we need to rush it through because we need grass growing right away. We want to seed this fall,
right?
So we can get grass growing for spring for the tournament.
Well, I would definitely. I mean, Greg would be the point because that's that's his area right there from his commission and stuff like this. So get the plans right to Greg. I mean, ASAP. What your ideas are, and we can do a special meeting or something like that if we have to do it. So
I mean, it's
basically where these two ball fields are.
Putting a soccer field right there.
The map.
What size are we talking about?
The map, it's on the screen right now. That black line that's at the top.
Okay, we're different. So we're over here then, right?
No.
Nope. Just let me finish. The top line where the arrow meets that black line, that is the north of the field, and that was the area they were given permission to build on. If you go to where the baseball field is, that's where they have started building the field. And that black line that runs between the baseball and the soccer field is essentially the parking lot. Yes.
So we're right now we're rectangle, we're 140 by 230 this way right here. So the sled hill is here. We are 140 wide.
So you guys already graded and everything then?
Graded.
It's all done.
And what size field are you putting in? The large one?
It's a 9x9, so it's this size right here.
That's that one right there.
Where's the shed going to go?
We'd like it to be right here.
If you look at the...
that's our handicapped parking there.
It keeps going in and out.
It's the light that I think... that George is standing right there or whatever. Move George a little bit. See, I think if he goes back by the pitcher... it like gets better.
Yeah, those... It's the rabbit ears, guys. It's the rabbit ears.
This current building.
Right.
It's all the building next to it. Or
it's gyro, right next to the gyro.
Right? Yeah, right in, right in there.
That's designated handicap parking, though, isn't it? Right there by the building there?
Signs there, are there?
There's no signs or anything.
No, that's part of the master plan, the whole thing about, everything's like a giant piece to the giant puzzle, the whole goal for everything, you know,
but
so.
I guess we thought this would be a good spot based on there's already a building there.
Yeah,
why not make a little complex a building? But whoever would make most sense, wherever's closest to water and sewer, obviously would be best for us.
Do you know if the haunted house has any water or sewer hookup? They have nothing.
Don't
right?
know.
I think they got power.
They have power, but I don't believe they have water or sewer.
Okay.
And see, that's the concern. No, we don't want you to put something in that there's a right master plan for something.
Well, especially
else.
for the
building. The field, we don't really care about. If in 5 years that's to go, so be it.
I understand what you're saying, but at the same time, you don't want to spend a lot of money and you're in there for a year or two. I mean, you just want
True.
To be in there long term. We want you to be in there long term, too. I don't want you to. Let's say what is it, Gyra? Gyra do baseball, right? If Gyra comes up in a year and says, hey, we're ready to put our fields in there, you know, that's you guys have wasted your money, and I hate to see you do that. You know?
I appreciate
that. I just
want
to make sure everybody's on the same page.
I don't know that we've really been wasted our money other than because we're out of room.
No, I understand, but, you know, the money you're building it there, okay, the five-year plan calls for the baseball fields to go. So right now the baseball fields are slated to be there. And hypothetically, the Gyra comes here and says, hey, we're ready to put our baseball field. You guys have put all that dirt, graded, wasted all that effort because baseball fields are going to go in there, right? Mm-hmm. So that's what I mean. I just want to make sure everybody's on the same page and we're all headed
it
in the same direction.
It can be all changed to what you want, but it's got to be the community involvement
exactly.
through the process. And, it's not a big, we can make this happen, you know what I mean? But we got to do it the right way, though.
Mm-hmm.
And right now, Rec's really kind of underneath the spotlight, so we got to make sure we do everything right. And the safety feature, though, we got to figure out what you're going to do. Are you talking about telephone poles again or what you currently have?
Well, you know, we discussed between us about, you know, our field would be, you know, this. Talked about a fence across here and then down, and then still utilizing that wooden parking.
Because you're going to need that parking.
Yeah, right. So we could close that off so kids aren't – I mean, kids walk across this all day long.
Right.
As it is.
I think the concern has always been in the past, at least – and again, I'm aging myself, but back when we used to do – you know, those logs, yeah, they were great. Cars wouldn't drive. That ball go across, that kid go shooting across into the parking lot.
Yeah.
That's the concern, you know.
Yeah,
kids all amped up to get the ball, you know, type of thing.
So. Well, the way it would probably stand, be cars parked – as they are today,
right.
parked up against our fence here, you know, facing that field.
Right.
And so then we'd have a fence more than, there's a cable now, which is
right.
It's all crappy, you know how it looks.
Right.
So we would have something better, a little bit more, you know, secure, I suppose, to keep kids contained, to keep the soccer balls in the field. That would run from basically the tree line out and then back across to keep.
Primarily to keep vehicles from driving on the field.
Right. With the cable.
All right, so priority, you want, do you want this building for this? Island Fest tournament too, then, right?
We do.
Okay.
What do you guys
know about water and sewer? You guys don't really know nothing, right? You didn't submit a plan to any other departments or nothing, then, right?
This is step one for us right here.
Okay. All right.
We haven't dug the footings yet, so we're starting Monday. One person got it.
Wow. This is moving fast, you guys. Okay. All right. So let's talk about the fields. The fields, get with Brandy, Greg, you know what I mean? Let them, you know, the plans, the where the field's going to be. What are you going to do for the safety thing for the fence? We got to do that first. Grass is going to be the most important thing. As far as the hookups, Brandy, they got to go through DPS and through their first. And then what's our planning commission? Right?
Yeah, well.
It's got to be all code.
Right, so it's more than just the CRC. We have to give them the blessing, and then they also have to get permits through the building department, and then plan department has to approve these as well.
And that's all fine. We're well aware of that.
I'm fine. With the building, I think it's good to have the concessions. Great for your group and everything. That disappointing you guys started on a field without us knowing about it, because I thought you guys were going to work through the north end. What do we want? We got to do a motion to approve this to move forward with the building.
Well, I think first we need to see some kind of drawing and some kind of plan.
I would think that our next meeting is November 19th, which is earlier than it typically is. It's not a month in between. We only have 3 weeks because we're moving up because Thanksgiving. I would think it'd be appropriate for them to have a plan, whether, you know, includes like working with the water excuse me, our planning department, you know, with the like when the next meeting is, you know, just have a, this is what we're going to do. With your blessing, the CRC, I'm going to, this is our plan. This is when we're going to go to the building department. This is when we're going to the planning commission. And working with the planning department, it might be an admin review. It might not even be where you have to go to the committee. So that's just some of the steps that you're going to have to find out.
So I talked to Lori in the building department, and she didn't even have site plans, underground utility plans for this area at all.
And so I have a call in to the township engineer.
I asked her where water and sewer were. She had no idea and couldn't find nothing. And not cutting her down, saying she had nothing to look at.
There might not be anything out there. I don't know.
I have a call under Rains to get that information.
Well, I mean, we did a lot of demolition there. That was the, where's the pool at? I mean, that was
yeah, but I doubt all
more
any,
south.
I doubt in the utilities. And really, I think what we want to see is just what you've got here. Show us where you want to put the building. Mm-hmm. You know, tell us what size is. We're not talking about construction diagrams or anything like that. Just say, hey, this is where it is.
You know? Footprint. We want the footprint where you want it in there. That's
absolutely right.
Okay. Mm-hmm. When it comes to the height and what everything else goes in it, that's other
building
department going to be controlling that.
That's fine.
But also,
but I would say the plan needs to say that they're going to the planning department and the building department to get the appropriate. And then I think we need to have an agreement with them, and that's one of the things that on my large to-do list is to have an agreement with all the community groups. So this is what we're doing. This is what the rec department does. So we have it. And I would think with Giza, we need to have that building on there, that they're maintaining it. If something goes wrong, that it reverts back to them, and just to protect the rec department and the township.
All right. So are you clear of what you basically got to do? Are you, this should work out okay, whatever? I mean,
just so we're all on the same page, you guys bring something to us on November 19th is the next meeting? Something
yes.
on November 19th, mm-hmm. showing what you propose for the field, safety, and all that stuff, and where you want the building. And what I suggest we do is we invite Gyra Baseball here so that they can also be part of the discussion, so everybody's on the same page.
Well,
we are in the process of doing, I'm getting ahead of myself, but on our, this is our year to do our five-year master plan.
Right.
So by actually the next meeting, I'm going to give you a prelim of the plan of what we've done, what we're taking out. So we're starting the five-year master plan now, and it'll be completed by February. So in that time, we will have three community group meetings, and we will be touching base with all the community groups and the public. So we're in the, I mean, it's kind of all happening at a good time. I know you guys want to go fast on this, but we're in the process of doing that, and maybe baseball doesn't want a field there anymore.
No, but
I have no idea,
but we need to get them on board.
Yes, I do agree.
Especially if we're going to change the five-year plan and make sure they don't have a problem with it, because they may be sitting back going, oh, yeah, we're good. Those are our field. That's our area. So I just think next meeting you guys bring information. Gyra Baseball have a representative. We'll invite them to come. Hopefully
they
do
come. Whether they come or not, that's up to them.
Right, and then, you know, can have a dialogue and figure out what we're doing and where we're going. Does that work for you guys?
Well, it does, but meanwhile, we've missed our whole. We're almost at the end of our growing season as it is. I mean, we would really like to get grass. Some we have a hydro seed guy come. We'd like to have a hydro seed guy come out next week on this thing.
The only thing I can offer you, it's like a roll of a dice.
Yeah.
I mean, you guys would just go all in and say, okay, everything will go fine. And
if it doesn't,
then you've done that for nothing, like what Greg said.
Unfortunately, I mean, I hate to see you guys do it. That's all. I just want.
Well, we're knee deep into this thing now.
Right.
I mean, stopping now kind of shoots. We won't have the field for the tournament.
Right.
And that's the whole basis of what we're
tournament's
doing.
Tournament's in the spring, I take it.
May 20th.
During
Island Fest weekend.
Island Fest.
I see. I'm going to have to wait.
Yeah, May. End of May.
Okay.
It's the same weekend as Island Fest.
Well, let's do that then. So we got and again, I'm probably being a little dense here, and I apologize. But you guys will bring something November 9th showing a footprint.
19th.
Sorry.
19th. buildings,
animation. Footprints, and all that. Hopefully, we'll have Gyra Baseball here. Everybody will be on the same page. And then you guys keep marching, hopefully. You know what I mean? It'll be all set for the spring.
Well, with the building.
Well, yeah, the building's. I don't think the building's really going to be.
To clarify, you're saying both the field and the building. You want information in the next meeting.
If you know, and all we're looking for the building is a footprint.
That's fine. That's not a problem.
So we're
not
start the dialogue.
We could possibly still work on the building this year. I mean, with weather is on our side, but it's the field that we're most concerned about. So you want me to halt progress on the field right now?
No,
that's on you.
That's you.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
it's your call.
We'll continue.
Roll the dice
without your blessing.
Yes.
And rolling the dice. Okay.
Yep. And I don't know if you guys know your counterparts in baseball at all. Do you know who runs that or anything?
Still separate from Gyra, right?
I don't know. Yeah. I have no idea.
But I figure you maybe talk, whatever.
Yeah, maybe they could reach out. I mean, I'm thinking, is there any way to fast-track the field? If they could, did you tell them who baseball is? They talk to baseball?
I've never been able to contact anybody at baseball. But again,
I have the contacts at baseball. Okay. I can
but again, in fairness to them, they need to be involved in it. Mike, they've already started the fields. And correct me if I'm wrong, guys, but they're going to continue with the assumption that it's going to be
everyone will be fine.
Yeah.
Well, I do think that they need to have your blessing them. I think that you want to set protocol that you can't just do whatever you want, that this is township property.
Now we're aware of it.
As a board, if you're okay with it, you need to be okay with it. But if you're not okay with it, then we need to say come to the next meeting. I just want the board to be okay with it and not – I don't want it to be a
– You're okay with us continuing at our own risk?
I am. I'm comfortable with them continuing on their own
risk. All we're doing is – grading the grass there now and planting brand new grass.
Right.
We're not harming anything. We're just wasting
our time. You guys continue as long as you guys understand that if baseball for some reason wants those fields, you got to walk away.
And we've been aware of that since the day we put a shovel on the ground.
Yeah. Then I don't have a problem with.
Does anyone else have a problem with that?
Yeah, I do have a problem with that.
Do everything according to the right way it's supposed to be done.
Okay.
So whether you do it or not, I just don't want to get criticized for doing stuff the wrong way again. Even though we thought we did it the right way.
Right.
You
know what I mean? I know, that's right.
Right way.
John down here's got.
Yeah, John?
Yeah, I got a couple questions on this. First of all, if baseball already has a plan for those fields, we need to get with baseball, period. No questions about it. And a change of what they're thinking about. And so that those guys can go ahead and do what they want to do. But first, baseball has to be consulted. And then second, what about the gyro building that's there now?
It's a gyro building, yes.
It's not a Giza building.
I know, but what kind of usage is the gyro building?
It's football, and it has storage.
Cheerleading and football, as far as
I mean, there's no haunted house anymore, correct?
No.
I mean, do we need two buildings?
Well, it's two different groups. Organizations.
Yeah. Well, I know it's two different organizations, but
gyro takes up a lot of space with their football.
Yeah, I mean,
if they're using the space, that's one thing. I mean, if they're not, then we.
But we actually went down this road before with Tom. Tom wanted to talk about building a building concessions 10 years ago.
Yeah.
You know, so I mean, this whole process. I think we actually got shut down by the fire marshal, didn't we? For storing gasoline. Remember, we went through hiccups.
Well, we had a temp.
Yeah.
We had a concessions, temporary concessions shack kind of thing. It was there next to the building, next to the gyro building that we used for cider and that type of thing. You know, but I just didn't want to have two buildings if we only need one. That's all.
Well, yeah, we have no access to that building, and we need a building. We have over 500 kids in our in-house travel program. We have over 100 teams coming this spring to our tournament, which is 1,400 children plus families. That's a lot of people coming. We need space.
I'd like to put a playscape in your area too.
Yeah, well, you know, we're growing and growing, and we need to give I don't know if anyone's ever been to a Plymouth or any cool soccer fields. They have fantastic facilities. We have nothing.
Right.
We have a porta potty sitting here.
And what are you guys doing? I commend for your this tournament you guys had. It kind of stinked. It rained.
Yeah, it was horrible with the rain.
But I mean, I wish you the best with the weather. I think it's all good things. I mean, I've never seen a lot of things. You know, I don't know if you guys seen the signs they have too. You guys see the new signs and stuff that they put up too. So
yeah.
You know, you guys are doing good things.
Yeah, we cut the grass ourselves. We pay for that.
Over that from the township. Yeah.
And we commend you for your work. We appreciate it. Thank you.
Just want to follow procedures.
We're happy to do that. I mean, obviously, we jumped the gun a little on the field, but
unknowingly,
yes, we really honestly thought we were good to go. We really did. Knowing we had the ability to go to the north, we figured, well, we'll just go to the west, and it would be better. We're not cutting any trees down, so we thought it was a safe bet.
Don't worry about those trees. I mean, we went through there.
The area was proposed that, because this had come to the CRC prior, so that area was pre-approved, and I told them that they did not have to come to the CRC for that because it had already been approved at an earlier time, that anything that was done to the west of it needed to come to the CRC because it was in the rec master plan for the baseball fields.
So we clear then? We good then, you guys? Are everyone happy then? You can move forward and come build you guys on the 19th then, right?
Sounds good.
Well, I think you make a motion that the CRC approves for them to build the field based on the contingency that they know that it's temporary until the master plan's done and it's approved and everyone's on the same. So,
anybody want to second what Brandy just said?
I didn't understand what you said.
I second it.
You still have the baseball thing in the middle of it, though, somehow.
Baseball walks up.
They don't even approve.
There's no way. The baseball.
I heard the word contingent.
Can I say this? You guys are doing what you're doing right now. Correct me if I misspeak, but you're not going to stop unless we tell you to stop, right? And right now, we just want to make sure baseball's on board. Can't we table this until the 19th? Get baseball in here. Get you guys in here with your plan. And then we can either approve it or disapprove it then based on having all the parties available. I think anything we word now is just going to be kind of, you know.
But see, they're going to miss their growing season. That's
but correct me if I'm wrong, guys. They're not stopping.
Right, okay. Okay, correct.
You guys are going to keep going.
Okay.
So really, I
what?
It's just all I'm saying is that you're giving them permission to
no,
do
we're not.
So.
They're doing it at their own risk.
Right.
We haven't granted anything right now. We're not going to grant anything until the 19th.
That's fine. Okay. That's
and they're proceeding at their own risk with the understanding that it might all be for naught. And until we get the baseball in here and get them on board with what you're doing and what they want to do and everybody's agreement, we'll just table this. This is what my motion is. Let's table this until the 19th. You guys are going to bring more information to us, plus
for final approval, basically, right?
Right, right.
For approval.
What the field going to look like, where the fence is at, and stuff like that. And we're going to get baseball in here and make sure that they're on board with it, too. Okay?
Hmm?
If they're not on board or if there's discussion, we'll work it all out then. I think that's the way to go.
Okay.
Personally. That's just me.
But just a motion would concrete that on both sides, that they know it, you know it, it's on the official record.
I think it's on the record now that we're not giving them permission, that you're proceeding at your own risk.
I got a little discussion, though. If they hadn't have said they were already building, our only role is to agree it's a good idea for the township and keep it moving.
We don't know if it's a good deal for the township in the sense that we've, the five-year plan is giving that property to the baseball crowd, okay? Right now, baseball crowd's out there sitting there thinking, hey, we got room for baseball fields. They come to us and say, hey, we're ready to build our baseball fields. Well, we've given them to the soccer guys. So we got, my thought is we got to get both parties in here, get them all on the same page, and it'll be good for the community. It's that we got to make sure everybody's on the same page.
It's perfect conflict before it happens.
Right,
exactly.
Right.
That's
right.
Or it's as simple as the soccer field stays until their 5-year window.
No, and that may be, they may say, hey, we're not going to be out there.
We're not ready. It very well be the case.
But we got to give them the opportunity to preserve.
Within a month, they could say, you know, it'll be in writing in our master plan. It won't be in our master plan, maybe. You know, maybe the master plan will say it's official soccer fields. It's just currently in our rec master plan, it says that that area is designated for baseball fields. So, again, we're going through the process right now. So, by doing that, we might find that they don't want to build baseball fields. They don't have the money to do it, or maybe they've been fundraising. They're ready to go. And we just don't know that. That's why we update the master.
You might want to stick with the baseball fields at the school. They got an infrastructure already started there, and they want to build from there. Who knows? You know what I mean?
Okay.
So you never know.
Fair plan.
Sounds good.
Right.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Appreciate time.
Oh,
here. Well, wait. These guys can clear out.
No, he's gonna speak.
He's going to speak for soccer?
No, I think he's got comments about that.
Okay. Tom Snyder, 84-48 Rucker.
Okay.
Years ago, when the football fields were put in, they were put in with the agreement when Giza went and fought to help Gyra get the football fields in, that if we ever had tournaments, we would be able to use those fields for a soccer tournament. The idea was, which way should I be looking? The idea was is that we would take care of the fields prior to the tournaments and take care of them after, but we'd do it in conjunction with Gyra so they knew what was going on. So basically what they were looking for is us to possibly seed the fields, us being Giza, sorry. Giza seed the field in the fall before. They would seed the field in the spring after the tournaments, after the fields get all beat up, possibly reseed again and roll it so they would be ready for football season. And I think they're doing that, Brandy, with the conjunction that possibly water would be needed, because depending on when tournaments are, would depend on whether the seed would have a chance to grow or not, so there would be some water needed for there. But that was part of the agreement back with Greg Kish and all of those other gentlemen that were there for that. So that would be a possibility of three fields there right off the bat. I don't know what the grading is on the football fields right now. That would be something you would have to talk to Gyra about, but I would think it'd be easier to make those smoother now than it would be to build a new field and try to get that ready for spring.
That might have been an arrangement between Giza and Gyra on their own. I don't remember it coming over to
there was
the
something
commission.
That we had talked, the two organizations talked about.
They probably did make together, whatever,
right.
But nothing came
but,
to this
but that might that. Be the quickest way to get fields together, because they already have grass on the fields. They're going to be done practicing there probably within a couple of weeks.
Was that
seeding could be
was done. That agreement done when they they were all one organization?
No, no. It was long after that.
That's when we paid a dollar to lease the property over there for them to build the football fields. That was that part of that thing. But all we did for that was just strictly for football. What had a region with Giza, right. I don't recall anything. Or maybe Tim knew about it then, maybe.
Tim did. I believe Dale was part of the discussion.
This is on my to-do list. It's not taking things away or giving to one or the other, but we just don't have anything in any kind of formal agreement with our community group. And that's the hard part because, for instance, with football, they have a new president. I'm new. So it's like, well, who does what? You know, so, you know.
The water wheel. You know, well, water costs money, blah, blah, blah. It's always wreck. You know?
Well, that's one of my winter projects is once we get past this building is to really sit down with all the community groups and just kind of put it all in writing. So it's, we have it, you know, if I'm not here anymore, if they're not here anymore, there's turnover that we have an agreement. Can it change? Absolutely. You know, it's a rolling agreement, but we don't have anything in writing. I just think that we need to have something in place to protect both sides. So with the when they took over doing the fields, mowing and taking care of it, we have an agreement with that now. So everything's kind of in writing, and it's just having, I know paper trail is horrible sometimes, but we just need to have those agreements in writing so both sides are protected. So we're doing what we say, they're doing what they say, and everyone's happy. Right. So it's just a matter of sitting down with all the, you know, I've met with all the group leaders, but we haven't really put pen to paper and wrote everything down. So that is one of the projects I will be doing, whether it's during the master plan process or, you know, throughout the winter. But that is something that we will be doing to get kind of all of our
ducks
cards
in a row.
Yep.
But he does bring up a good point. I mean, we can help facilitate that to use those fields and everything like that, too.
That would be great because the tournament this year, we tried. Kevin reached out to Jaira and asked if we could use the football field for us turn into a soccer field for the tournament, and they were adamantly opposed to it. I mean, they went and had a fit.
Okay, that is not their property, okay? So, you know.
The guy lost his mind. We even brought a trailer on there where the guy was taking pictures, you know, taking photos and that, and they flipped out. So we'd love to use the football field for soccer. It'd be fantastic. We wouldn't be Bill's field if we could use that.
There's a new president, though, football, right? You're saying?
John Howard.
Maybe the mentality's changed a little bit. I don't know.
Is it the same guy we talked to?
John was the guy last year. So
they went nuts.
I don't know the bad blood between Geese and Jaira.
I don't either.
It's 25 years old, but.
Well, I think just coming from a standpoint, would you want football on soccer? Like, what if they had a tournament? Would you want them playing football and messing up your soccer fields with football if they did a football tournament? You know, it goes both ways. They're trying to groom their field, and they're taking pride in their field for football. So, you know, I would say that their
field,
agreement
these are our soccer fields. There's a big difference. I get it, but we offered to seed and fix and repair and do all that.
I haven't talked to them about it. I'm saying from their point of view, if the situation was reversed and they wanted to come just for a special tournament or one weekend, you guys would probably really hesitate to say, well, those are our soccer fields. So I just think there needs to be some conversations before. I'm not saying it's a bad idea, but I think we need to bring them into it.
Absolutely, they would have to be brought into it. But I will tell you that if it would help, I'm sure we can get some of the gentlemen that were part of that original agreement to come talk to both organizations to make sure there's an understanding. If it wasn't for soccer's help, there possibly wouldn't be those football fields there. And that was the gentleman's agreement at that point in time. And sometimes bringing the old guard in for something like that might be something that might be helpful.
I think we need to get a family therapist and get everybody in the same room and all join
hug it out.
Yeah.
We're not going to take much more time. We've all sat down before. I've been to the Jaira board meeting. They invited us. It just didn't make sense for us to be part of it, what their direction was, what our direction is. You know, I'm not sure how much you know about Giza, but we're 500 strong, probably going to be upwards 700 next year, kids playing soccer on the island. We need space. I've gone to Ted to look for land. You know, he's trying to find me some places to put fields that maybe the airport or whoever let us use. You know, we've gone as far as we built our own field over at the middle school. Well, the high school thought it was such a great field. Guess what? Sorry, guys, you're gone. You can't use our field anymore.
The field that you built?
The field that we built. So what we said was, well, hey, we're going to take all our nets and all our goals. No, you can't do that. Well, they're ours, so technically we can. So it's you know.
I guess that's what we're trying to prevent.
Absolutely.
We gotta use Brandy as more of, as the conduit between these groups and stuff.
Absolutely.
You know, I mean, there's joint agreement. This property is a Grows Eel, okay, property for every community group. Someone wants to have a kite club or something like this. Well, there's no reason why they can't be using these fields or something. You know,
that's I go up
it
there.
Needs to not be a gentleman's agreement and put in
right.
writing. And that, again, what I will
sole
be.
Sole discussion at the recreation
It's just
director.
Amazing that, I mean, I'm with Tom in this, and my daughter's been playing for 6 years. And I remember when I first started with my daughter, there was two teams. We have 26 teams that play select travel, and we have 150 kids that play on Sunday here. There's 500-600 people over at the park. We're just trying to make it better for everybody. And, you know, when you say, is the city going to have to maintain our shed or our building? Absolutely not. We're going to do it ourselves. We'll maintain it. We cut the grass. We take care of the property. It's going to continue to be that way. We're not going to put anybody in jeopardy. You know, when we say we don't want to use football land, they're over practicing our soccer fields. I see them over there, but I wouldn't say nothing. You know, it's community property, like you said. We're just trying to make it better for our kids because come Island Fest time, and that's why I asked to come to the Island Committee meeting, you know, we had 65 teams play here last year. They're talking up to 120 teams showing up this year. So 120 times 15 kids a team, you know, what is that, 1,800 people? Plus their parents, you're talking additional 5,000-7,000 people in the course of 3 days on the island. We're just trying to help the community. I mean,
and I'm not trying to give you a hard time either.
I'm not
but
saying you are.
We just have to follow protocol because
I'm completely fine with that.
We can't have chaos.
Otherwise, why do we exist?
Right.
Right.
We can't have chaos.
We just got to make sure you do it the right way. And
I'm fine with that. And we understand that if baseball walked in tomorrow and said, here's our $100,000. We're going to go build two fields today. We'll say, well, hey, there you go. We graded the land for you already and have at it. You know, so we understand that.
Okay. All right. So we'll see you guys on the 19th then with some plans for both of the things. Yes, Tom.
A couple other housekeeping things. The Gyro Clubhouse isn't just used for football. They store all their stuff in there. Giza will not have room for any of this stuff. If you've seen that thing that has been open, all of the football stuff is downstairs. Baseball and basketball is upstairs. There's no room for soccer. So there is a building that's needed. The water, it comes up to the road just on the opposite side of the Gyro Clubhouse. The agreement was when they tore down the original clubhouse that Gyro owned, that the township brought water over to that building. So whenever water was going to be needed, they would be there. And as far as the original building that was talked about, it died. That original discussion died through bureaucracy. Brandy, we might want to have you get involved because what had happened is the fire department has their own regulations for it. The gentleman who comes once a month down to Lori's area, down in the engineering area, had his own idea, making sure materials and everything else were done. Then it has to go to the planning commission, and then it has to go to the board level. So it's probably something that's going to take a little while when it came to do that. So it might be something that you could maybe expedite for these gentlemen because they do need the room, they do need the storage, and as much as soccer has grown, and I do understand the board's reluctance when it comes to them moving fast.
I would prefer that they go through Dale, actually. I think Dale would be a great point.
But they need to come to us first with a plan, and then we can bless it, and then they...
But I'm talking about this whole thing with all these different departments and stuff.
Well, I think he's just referring to the building right
now. Yeah, the building right now. I think they could use somebody's help.
They're going to bring us information on the 19th. We'll bless it if we like it, and then they're going to have to... They have to go to the building department. They're going to have to... There's protocols they're going to have to follow that are out of our...
Right, but you don't have to do nothing with the building department.
No, but what he's asking is, can I help go through the process with them?
I will tell you, doing it individually the first time, I felt that there was a lack of cooperation on the township's behalf. So maybe if a different department head or possibly our township manager could get involved to help expedite this, they do need the room. You can't imagine the amount of nets, the amount of equipment, everything else they're going to need to run this tournament. They need help in particular if this is going to be done.
Everyone understands that.
Okay.
The problem is they got to follow the proper procedures.
I get it, but I'm telling you they're going
to
need help.
Well, they're dealing with that. Ted will be able to guide you, too. All right, thanks, guys. Phew. The 19th, it's going to be quicker, okay?
Yes.
7:30.
He wants to come in at 7.
Yeah.
Thanks, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Okay, that was a doozy. Okay, chairperson's report.
That's you.
Okay, a little update with the commission. The township board had a meeting wanted to have a meeting. When was the last meeting that we had? It was about the splash park was on the agenda. A few of the fellow commissioners joined us there. It's basically everything that we did, the discussions that we had at this level, it really wasn't brought forward to the township board. Very disappointed that night. I felt that I was actually put on the witness stand about this whole thing. I thought we did everything to the T. We presented all the information about this. We discussed this numerous times. This money that we want for the splash park was not going to be, you know, that be used for roads or anything else at all. This is a borrowing thing. Same thing we did for the seawall. We borrowed money to build a seawall because, you know, we needed a seawall. You know, we borrow money for things all the time and we pay them back. Interdepartmental loans. Our liaison, Tom Malvesto, he did vote against this, saying that he would not spend the money, which I was very disappointed because I never had a discussion with Tom about this. And I think a few of the other commissioners that were there were also a little disappointed in that and surprised by the comments. So I guess what I'm asking of this commission is that I guess we have to double check everything, cross our T's, dot our I's, because I'm not sure of what's being presented once it leaves this commission. I have no idea what's going on. I have no communication with the liaison. You know, I didn't even get communication that he was going to be absent today. I had no idea. So anyway, I'm very disappointed. That's why I wanted you to report to you guys. Any questions about the splash park, about how it went down, or anything else from me? No?
Well, Chair.
Yes, Mike.
I do want to add my comments because I attended that township board meeting. And we did, even that evening, take the time to walk them through the steps that have been occurred in the last 6 months. But when it came time for vote, I was shocked that way the township board voted. They could have tabled the motion. Instead, they voted to cancel the contract and accept a liability of a cancellation that could be $100,000. As a taxpayer, I was shocked at the five members of the township board that voted for that proposal. So I was embarrassed as a member of this commission. I was angry as a taxpayer that they would put the township liable for that kind of cancellation fee without discussing it. And actually, it was embarrassing as a member of the township that some of the board members were rude, and they weren't even civil. And I guess I'm naive. I didn't know that's how those people act in those meetings. They were kind of slamming each other in addition to us. So those are my comments. And I certainly was disappointed that our liaison changed his vote. And what we thought, he was in favor of what we were proposing, and that night to hear him vote against it was shocking to me as a member of this commission. It was disappointing. Thank you.
Any other comments?
What's our status now as far as what's going on?
Currently, the vote from the township board was to cancel the contract and have Tom Assorti, our township lawyer, work on an exit strategy, I guess.
And has any of that come to light yet?
Not to my knowledge.
Okay.
Anything else? Oh, no. And back to the pool area. So the splash park thing, which, you know, everything was approved in May, and we're moving forward like we always do. The commission does not do anything and follow everything through. We get updates from our director. But anyway, since this happened, Brandy had to go back to the board because of the Marsite money that you had budgeted already, but it came back more because we have to, you know, do it right now because it's going to be different now. But so we got that through. That did pass, no problem. So we are going to start with that. So our pool can open, you know, for the spring. All right. So that was a special meeting for that. All right. So that's all I got to report then. All right. Director's report. What do you got for us, Brandy?
Well, you guys went over a lot already. The Water's Edge. No, I never don't speak. The Water's Edge restaurant, we are still in negotiations with Smokies. We're hoping to have everything wrapped up for the November 9th Township Board meeting to bring a lease forward. They're moving forward on the cogs in the wheel that they need to do, and we're moving forward with drawing up the lease and, you know, getting all the finite items worked out. So we're hoping that will take place in the November 9th meeting.
Randy, what's the status then of Sharkies? Are they a month-to-month lease or?
No, their lease goes through the end of the year.
Okay, so, all right.
So they're still paying, and they're there, and plan on being there through December, and then come January 1st, the new owners can come, our new leasees come in and start cleaning up and changing and doing what they want to do. And
once we get an agreement, though, with them. Once we get an agreement with the new
yes.
leasees. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, I have a question, though. Are we going to write a letter, though, that we definitely want to terminate? Have our township lawyers send a letter that we definitely want to terminate and a date that there ain't going to be no delay in our new tenants taking possession?
There's already, well, one, the lease ends, and two, we gave them the acknowledgement letter that the lease was ending and that new tenants were coming in effective January 1st. So that has already been sent to them.
Okay.
Walt, I got a question for Brandy. Just in the contract that is being written up with the restaurateur, if there's anything in there that affects the marina, could you make me aware of it?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Yep.
And Brandy, how long... once Smokies does start, how long are they saying it'll take to revamp the restaurant?
I think their hopes is to have a soft launch in March to get ready for golf season and then full swing by April.
All right, anything else about the restaurant? All right, Brandy, what else?
Okay. Well, the kayak launch is in and out.
It's already out now?
Yeah. It was put in, it was there about a month and active and usable. The parking lot's done, it's graded, it looks beautiful out there. And then we'd have Hearst, or Boat Hoist USA, or Hearst Marina. They were in the area and they were pulling docks and everything, and so they had to ask if they could remove ours for us. And it was towards the end of the season, and we had not had an agreement with Wayne County yet to have a ribbon cutting ceremony. So I did get in touch, and we were playing phone tag, and we were playing phone tag with Hearst Marina, and so we will schedule the ribbon cutting ceremony for the beginning of spring season.
Okay. What was the cost to remove it?
I believe it's $300, $500.
So it's going to be $500 each way, in and out, probably? We got to remember this for when we talk about kayak fees. We got to start discussing kayak fees. We got to have that in the works for spring.
Would you like me to place it on the next agenda?
That would be great if we could start discussing that.
Happy to do that. Water's Edge, the golf portion, the building has been demoed. It's completely gone. The spoils are gone. It's a nice, well-paved area. Our graveled area. Three companies had submitted bids to rebuild the building, and we have our equipment list ready to go. And I handed everyone the list that I gave you. The contracts are going to be reviewed by the township manager, the finance director, our insurance agent, and myself, and then once we kind of decide on our final candidate, we will run it through the insurance adjuster that is working on our claim to make sure that everything that is in their proposed project is covered. There will be some items, no matter what we do, that the township will have to pay because we're moving the actual location of the building for safety reasons and better located within the property, but the insurance will not pay for any additional fees that it costs for us to move it. So utilities, so if it's 100 feet away, we have to pay that extra 100 feet of utilities. So it's anything that we have to pay that it's because it's on a new piece of property. The preliminary thoughts from the contractors was in the ballpark of about $30,000 to $40,000. That's an estimate at this point. So we're in the process of doing that, and I would hope to have everything ready to go in a couple weeks. So we're reviewing the contracts very soon, and it's estimated that the build time will be not until the end of February, beginning of March, because the prefab buildings take anywhere from 8 to 10 weeks to receive. So the hopes is to have the footings, the concrete structures in as soon as possible, so as soon as the equipment gets here, because you can't pour the concrete after the freeze. So we want to get those in before it's done, and then when the building gets here, we'll be able to build right away.
So your footprint, are you doing anything with footprint, making it bigger?
Right now, it's scheduled to be a 50 by 80 building, and before it was like 40
by 77 parts of it. Like, we had base of the building, and then we had a little extra, so this would make it more rectangular, and it'll be, instead of like 30, I think it was like 33,000 square feet, and it'll now be 3,300, it'll be 4,000 square feet. So it'll be slightly larger. It will have a little bit of a lofted area so we can put small supplies like 2x4s, PVC pipes, so not large, heavy items, but things to kind of get it off the ground and have the ability to have some storage.
So we're not talking about a metal roof no more? Or?
No, it'll still have a metal roof.
Okay.
Yep. So the information I gave you regarding the equipment, I just wanted to break down. This is the list of equipment that we are have narrowed it down that we would like to purchase. That is essentially the bare bones of what we need to operate the course. We do have some backup items that we had and need to replace, but those are a little bit farther down the list. We want to make sure our... You can see like the first like 10 items are what we absolutely need. And then the next four items are if there's enough money left over at the end. The insurance money that we have received, we received actual cash value on our equipment and contents. That is current value minus depreciation. We don't have total replacement on equipment, but we did have total replacement on the building. So if you look down under the building area, the first number listed, that's the actual cash value. So that is what we have received to date for the building. So if we build it, don't build it, they don't care. That's the money that they felt that that's what it was worth. If we rebuild it and current day costs, we get our depreciation back. That's the second number listed, and that's where it says RCV, and that's replacement value. The proposals are coming back in. Now, what is not included in the money that we received or the money we will receive to rebuild is architectural fees are not included. That will be covered. The design fees, the engineering fees, all that stuff, the project manager's fees, none of that stuff is included because, you know, if you don't rebuild, they're not going to give you those costs for a 30-year-old building. So those items will be covered, and that's why we are going to send a proposal to the adjuster that's working on our contract to make sure all those items are covered. And if they're not, then we either have to decide to ask the township for general fund dollars, or we cut back on the project, or, you know, we'd have to go from there. So that's why we're going to double check. Our little committee is going to get together, look at the proposals, decide which one we want, and then go back to our insurance adjuster to make sure that you know, that we're following proper protocol and everything that is in the proposals is covered by the insurance company.
Okay. Any questions about this, you guys? All right, moving on.
Okay. Winter storage has started, and haulouts for the winter season have been going on the last few weeks. Weekends, we've had some really busy. The last three weekends have been very busy at the marina hauling out boats. We've probably hauled out maybe 85% of the boats, so we're doing pretty good. We have two potential weekends left. I think our harbor master, Mr. Lang, is trying to get them all into one weekend, so we'll see how that goes. I know he's contacted the boats that are left that are at our marina to try to get them scheduled in for this weekend coming up, and then if need be, we have one more weekend, but then that's the last two weekends we're going to do haulouts. Centennial Farm, if you've been by there, the dog park fence is in. It looks wonderful. The people that I've been in contact with love it. It looks great out there. At first, I was a little concerned about putting a chain link fence in the farm setting because I like the atmosphere of the wood fences and it looked nice, but we went with a coated fence and it's green. It kind of blends in. I think it looks nice. It looked nicer than what I was thinking it was going to look like. So, Helena, if you have any comments.
I haven't heard anything bad at all.
Have you been by it?
Yeah, it looks nice.
Don't really notice it.
No.
See, it blends in. Oh, see, Ethel didn't even notice it.
Well, I said you don't notice
it.
We've been just doing cleanup at the farm. The flower beds were all cleaned up. The islands in the parking lot have been cleaned out. All the weeds, flowers are all gone out of there. So everything's been pulled out. We have mulch down, and then we'll we'll put our landscaping in come springtime. And then the guys are also, while we still have some nice weather, are working on the perimeter of the farm. There's a lot of the wood fencing. There's several trees that have fallen down in the last, I think, few weeks. So they're really concentrating on going around. We cut one tree down today. So we're just going around, cleaning up, fixing the boards that are broken. We just trying to do some work over at the farm. Yep. And then I feel like we've had a little bit of overshadowing with a lot of things that had been going on and with the fire, like a lot of our conversations. So I just want to take a minute just to kind of brag on some of the things that we've done that aren't fire related, that we are doing things beyond just working on the fire claim. So I think all of you know that we started our online registration this spring, and that was very successful in both the spring and now our fall classes. We've had a lot of people register. We're kind of getting, I think we're up to like 50 to 60% of our registrations are online now versus people coming into the office. So it's convenient. They can do it when they want. They can do it in their PJs with a cup of coffee in the morning or at night. So it's, I think it's been a well-received item. And we have the new design of channels that we've gotten a lot of compliments on. Easy to read. It, you know, people keep it longer. They don't just throw it away. Foot golf has been really successful. We had, I think probably by June or the beginning of July, we already covered our expenses on the product and the installation and all that good stuff. We've had over, we have over 300 rounds for the season just from foot golf. So one of the goals when Dale and I sat down at the beginning was to increase rounds. So we certainly did that by at least 300 with foot golf. So that was, I think, a good strong point. We did a lot of work on the pool house this year. It was painted inside. There was a lot of cracks. I didn't know it before this winter, but this winter was really hard on that, the pool house. We had the cement partitions in the shower area were pulling away from the wall. They weren't even attached anymore in both the men's and the women's restroom. So we had those fixed. We had it painted. They caulked. The company did an amazing job. And so we had to spend some money in there. And I'm hoping that, you know, through this master plan that we can put on there to do something with that building, either make it larger or at least make it where it's it can be used year round with the rink right there. You know, there's really no place for people to, you know, put their hockey equipment on, and so they have to like do it in their car and then kind of waddle out to the rink to play hockey. So it would be nice, the one, to have restrooms, and two, to be able to have a place for people to change and get into their hockey gear or their figure skating outfits. The kayak launch is another thing, the new restaurant, and then we did a lot of reorganizing with golf, with fees and league structures, and then also our rental fee over at the farm with the activity center, and kind of just restructuring how we do some of our processes. So we've talked a lot about the fire, and you know, the Splash Park has kind of, there's a little bit of a black cloud around that right now. So there's a lot of great things going on in the rec department. I just wanted to highlight some of those things.
Anything you want to mention about Bob?
And then just with the pool, we have, we said that we went to the board. We had in the budget to Marsite the pool. Well, Marsite is essentially the finish on the bottom of the pool. There was extensive damage to it. It was just the tile work around the pool needed to be replaced. The coping stones around, we were losing a ton of water through. If we didn't run the water, it by a couple of days, it was down below the skimmer line. So it was quite a bit more money than, and I went over this last meeting, it was quite a bit more money than what we had budgeted. So we did go to the township board to, we were able to use some other monies that we had within the budget, but it really needed to be done, and they've been working on it nonstop. So it's looking really nice. I mean, it looks yucky right now because they're done with the tile, and the tile looks beautiful, but they're chipping off the excess Marsite, and then they sand all that down, and then they lay the new Marsite, and then they put the coating over it, and then they fill the pool, and it has to cure for 28 days. So kind of we're under the gun here, so hopefully we'll get it done, and they're going to winterize the pool house, so we'll be good to go for the winter season. And hopefully with our new cover and the way that what they're doing, the Marsite, we won't have to do all the cleaning that we normally do in the early springtime. So So that's good. That's it. Oh, I'm sorry. Almost done. The master plan. We talked a little bit about it earlier. We are redoing the master plan, and it's an update to the master plan. It's not a total, redo of the master plan. We will, like I said, for next meeting, I'll give you a copy of just the bare bones of this is what we've already done. These are things that are no longer on the scope. And then we'll have a base document to work from. We'll also have 2 to 3 community meetings. We're meeting with our community groups and then citizens as a whole, not representing necessarily one particular group, but we will talk with our community groups and citizens as a whole to incorporate them into the process. And we're hoping to have that done and approved in February because I think our plan goes through April. So by the time we get it approved here, and then it does have to go to the planning committee, and it also has to go to the township board.
Are you bringing our planners in the next meeting then?
The planners?
Yeah, Brian is going to join us.
Oh, it'll be Brian or Michelle.
Are they going to come to our next meeting then? Okay. Any questions about this?
Yep. I got Brandy, the activities center.
Yes.
As far as the floor and the leakage in the roof and all that, how what's the latest?
Nothing
on that?
Is in store for the roof. I'm hoping to get some information on flooring. I think we have enough money in the budget to replace the floor, but I think what is going to happen is when we tear the floor up and we look at the sub flooring, I think we're going to have a lot more issues underneath there than we originally had anticipated. I was fairly new when I put the budget together, so I have to see what I want to get some flooring experts out here to see what type of floor they recommend with the multiple uses that we have, and then what they are anticipating it will cost, because it goes down a flooring company at that point. Well, they get carpenters involved. So I think the project might end up being a little bit more money than we had anticipated.
Well, besides that, before we do too much with the floor, we want to make sure the roof is fixed. So if we put a new floor in, we don't have leakage come down.
Well, I think the issues you might be talking about, we have rectified already. The gutters weren't aligned right with the overhang, and that was causing the water to come into the building. That had been fixed, so the water is no longer coming in. It's just the damage is already done.
Okay. Yeah, the roof was at a red bar, John.
All right, gotcha. All right. Then the Halloween parade.
Oh, yep. I was going to do that in my later comments, but this weekend is Halloween on the... What is it? Macomb. Halloween Macomb. The parade lineup starts at 10:15. The parade starts at 10:30. We will go down Macomb Street, and then all the kids get the trick-or-treat from 11 o'clock to 1 o'clock on Macomb. And there's Macomb Common, Spooky Commons, I think Chad calls it, that's at the end of Macomb and Meridian. So it should be a fun day, have by all. That's this Saturday.
What time they have to start lining up?
10:15.
Bring your pet.
Yeah.
You can ride your scooter.
You can ride your bicycle with the V-Pack. You can walk with the kids.
Is that a Harley?
Yeah, it's going to be a cold ride home, trust me.
Brandy, is this the place for you to talk about how nice your fall festival was?
Certainly. We had I can't tell you how a beautiful, perfect day that we had on the, I believe it was the 10th. We had over 300 people attend the celebration, and it was, like I said, it was a beautiful day out. We had a face painter. We had a balloon clown. We had a band playing. We had Farmer John did his animal shows, and he has his petting farm. That's always a big hit. We had cider and donuts. And then the animal shelter had a hot dog sale, and they were kind of doing a little fundraiser for Tails. It was a great day. I think everyone had a good time. All the kids got a pumpkin. We had a pumpkin patch this year. We had a little larger than pie pumpkins. All the kids got to take a pumpkin home with them. So it was nice.
Frisbee games going on.
Yeah, we had kid games going on. We had ping pong table out there, and then we had a beanbag toss and just a bunch of games out there for the kids to play.
It was good. All right, y'all done? Any questions for Brandy then? All right, old business. Thank you, Brandy. Any old business, new business. November 19th is going to be our next meeting. I do not anticipate a December meeting. All in favor of killing December meeting, say aye.
Aye.
All
opposed? I said if needed.
All right. She's no fun over there. Always planning here. All right. Subcommittee updates.
All right, we go right to the marina. Mike, got any marina updates, sir?
Oh, quick. I didn't know you were going to get me so quick. This work?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a boat. It's a video.
Oh.
So just real quickly, as Brandy said, Dockmaster Lang's bringing the boats out of the water. He's already got about 50 boats out of the water. This is our parking lot all year, but in the winter, it's our marina storage. There's room for 5 or 10 more boats. So if you have a boat and you're looking for winter storage, contact our director, Brandy, or our Dockmaster, Bob Lang, quickly, because as she said, we only have 1 or 2 more weekends, and the season's over. Thank you.
So someone can bring their boat to the lift there, and he'll take it out?
Well, if they would, they should call in advance, but yes, they could bring their boat to the haul-out slip, haul it out, we'll winter store it. We just need your proof of insurance and your payment for the winter. We'll be happy to store your boat.
Registration.
You don't have to be a member.
No.
Not.
Oh, this is a town. No, this is for... We'll store just about anybody's boat. You don't have to be you don't have to live here. You don't have to be a member of a club.
Okay. Good to know.
Yeah, the marina is open to the public, and then part of the marina is the West Shore Yacht and Cruising Club. So they're in our marina, but you do not have to be a member to use any of our privileges.
I like that video.
I like that video.
I also wanted to say that past Commodore, the West River Yacht and Cruising Club, Tom, was here last month. They did go to Smokey's in Wyandotte a couple weeks ago in the evening. They had over 50 of their members go there.
A meeting there?
Well, they had dinner.
Oh, okay.
They want to make nice with Smokey's. You know, the club, as he said, wants to be part of the community. They want to be a good friend with the new restaurant. They want to be a good partner with our marina, and I want to encourage that. Thank you.
They had originally RSVP'd for 17 people, and then they kept calling and increasing it, and they had, I believe they said 50 people showed up.
Wow.
Nice.
That's
nice.
Boy, like a love fest now, huh? All right. Any more questions for Mike? All right. Helena, anything at the farm you want to give us up?
Well, it's not about the farm. Well, it is about the farm. I just want to let everybody know that the Grosse Ile Equestrian team did very well this year.
All right.
Good. Didn't they win?
When they were reserve champion, what did they tell me?
They did win something.
They won the state, reserve champion in the states.
Really?
For their division. They were reserve champion in their region, and they were district champion. So it goes district, regional, and then state. They did really well.
I wonder,
this is the first year that they ever brought home a trophy.
Will the school put a little sign and placard over at the farm like they do for soccer and football?
Okay. We'll do that. We'll figure it out.
Come on, the school should recognize, right?
Yeah, you're right.
Well, are the winners students?
Yes.
Yes. It's a team. Yeah, it's a team that's
the high school team.
It's high school sponsored, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry. Yeah.
Varsity sport.
Good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's a varsity.
Outstanding. Good job to them.
Good. Did well. Mm-hmm. The best they've ever done.
Good.
Anything else?
Not for me.
Okay. Any questions for Elena? All right, moving on. Greg, you got all kinds of action happening in your area, buddy.
Yeah, I think my report pretty much summed up the whole beginning of the meeting, so I don't have to say anything.
Okay. Any questions for Greg? All right, moving on. All right, Ethel.
Greg, thank you. Your expertise, that discussion, if you weren't here, we would not have had the wherewithal to handle that right, so thank you.
Well, thank my motorcycle, because I had a flat tire. That was the only way I was getting here tonight.
Yeah, it's sitting over there.
And he uses Hayes as a Geico.
Sorry.
Oh, no. All right, Apple, now, Natalie kind of outdid you there last time, okay? Yeah. What kind of you got for your report for today?
A short one.
Oh,
how many pages?
I just have a few updates and a couple of reminders. The first and third Thursday cards are coming up, but they're 1 p.m. at Centennial Farm Activity Room. Second and fourth Tuesdays are the Grosse Ile Senior Club at 11:30 at the farm at the Activity Room. And upcoming trips, we have Turkeyville on December the 10th, Marshall Historical Society on their 36th annual Candlelight Walk Home Tour is December the 12th. And New Year's Eve, December 31st, Patsy Cline Theater on the Avenue, Wyandotte and Sinbad's Restaurant. They need a minimum of 10 participants per trip. And information and pricing is at Water's Edge Lobby, or you can call 734-676-2323. 2364. Sorry. And the senior holiday luncheon is Wednesday, December the 16th at 12:30 p.m. at Centennial Farm Activity Room. And then, I don't know how many of you have had an opportunity to read the Trenton Trib, which comes out the first of each month. But thanks to Pam Frusci and her efforts with the Writing Club and the Trenton Trib editors, there are many articles in the October issue from Groseal, including the Groseal Recreation Department one by myself. And my assignment for the club was the Recreation Department activities and news, and I was surprised to see it in the paper because I didn't realize they were going to put it in. And so I will be continuing to contribute to Groseal Recreation events in the Trenton Tribune once a month. Thank you.
You go, girl. All right. Any questions for Ethel? Now, your paper, though, any you guys have any notes, please give it to Brandy, though, like whatever you have written, so we can give it to Leah. All right. Thank you, Ethel. John, what do you got for us for schools and senior Olympics?
Let's go with Natalie first.
Natalie's the last one.
She gets her own time.
Yeah, she gets her own time.
Okay, well.
You want to just
all I
pass?
Have is what to echo Ethel's talking about with the Groseal News in the Trenton Trib. I'm working on a sports section to be put in there, and then I've talked with a couple people in Gyra football, and I'm waiting to get some more numbers to call. Had a good meeting with Jim Oakler. We're going to get information from them. So that'll be a big, that'll be a good part of the Groseal News as well.
Excellent.
Good.
All right, John, anything questions for John? All right, thanks. And what do you got for us?
For the place.
Look at the agenda.
See, it's a Sunrise Park.
Acknowledging it.
Thanks, Brandy. For the Playscape, the Kiwanis, the Key Club, and the Builders Club will be working at the Playscape this Saturday, October 24th, from 9 until about noon. They'll be kind of doing a fall cleanup and sprucing up. So if the public during the trick-or-treating on Macomb wants to stop by, see what they're doing, they'd love to see there. Also, the Kiwanis will be handing out candy at the Playscape sign, which is right on Macomb Street. So you can get some candy and then go see what they're doing at the Playscape. As far as Sunrise Park, please come enjoy Sunrise Park, which is the new name for the East River Road End Park, and before it's closed for the winter. Thank you.
All right. Any questions for Ann? All right. Thank you, Ann. Mm-hmm. Natalie, what do you got for us for school updates?
Okay. Boys.
Talk about calculus.
Well, I have a Cal quiz tomorrow, but boys tennis, girls golf, and the equestrian team all had finished their seasons in top 10 in the state. I'll have more standings next meeting, and I just found out that the girls cross-country team won the Huron League for the fourth year in a row just tonight. Students are working on the fall musical, The Seussical. It's a Dr. Seuss-themed musical. Performance dates will probably be like released by next meeting, so I'll have more on that next meeting. Steps for Strength Breast Cancer 5K Walk this Sunday, meeting at 1 p.m. at Groseal High School. It's run by two high school seniors, two kids in my grade, Sarah Daly, Jake Porcerelli. They did a great job last year, and I know they raised a lot of money last year for breast cancer awareness, and they'll be doing the same this year. So if you guys want to come support that, that'd be really cool. The rowing team, bottle can drop this Saturday at Kroger, 9:30 in the morning to 5. Please give me your cans.
I've been saving my cans since...
Please give me your cans. Thank you.
Why didn't I take it to Kroger? I wouldn't let her, so...
You should have a bunch. He drinks a lot.
Drink some more. Give me some cans by this Saturday. So, yeah, you can drop them off. We will be picking them up. If you want to leave them out, like, we'll come by. If you don't want us, like, knocking your door and bother you, put them in a bag, staple the piece of paper that we mailed you guys to that. If not, we'll just staple on there. Goes for the rowing kids. Put on your driveway. We'll come pick it up. We won't knock on your door or anything. It's a really big freezer for us. It's really important. And there's a home football game this Friday night at 7 against Southfield Bradford Academy, and I think this is our last for the season. I don't think we're going to playoffs.
Who won, what was the first, second, third, fourth for floats?
Seniors won. That's all I care about. I don't know the other teams. I just know that we won.
Rigged.
It was rigged. All right. Any questions for Natalie? All right. Thanks, Natalie.
Thank you.
All right. Extended public comment. Any extended public comment? Wally, what do you got for us?
I heard that. Super important. Wally Posey as Township Trustee. Strut your stuff, Crozio Recreation Commission. You do good work.
Thank you.
We've come up with something through BPAC. One of our newer members, probably you know him, Bob Fernsell, found a document while he was at a public welcome center on I-75 that allows us to put our literature into the centers. And he had a lightning strike about that. You know, he really thought and came back to our committee and said, you know, we do a lot of complaining about we can't get people to come here. We don't have anything to offer. We do have a lot to offer. And the opportunity for us to free place copies of channels, place the Greenway Open Space 16-page guide about our open spaces, things like that. The bike path, we have a young lady by the name of Jane Fijo. I'm sure you all know her. She's put together a rough draft of a trifold that talks about things to do related to bike paths. And, you know, our conversation boiled down to kind of like this. Look at our bike paths. We're the envy of a lot of communities. But a lot of communities don't even know we have bike paths. We have run into people that came to our events this year, Tour de Ile, Berdour, the lazy rides that BPAC has been promoting. All of these folks from off island that come, they say, wow, we're going to be back. So we've kind of tied into an opportunity here, I think, to promote us outside of the island. If we can get some cooperation, just think about telling people, how many people do you know have alpaca farm? Nobody out there knows. How many people out there do you know have a nice marina, a golf course, a pool?
Farm.
Let's keep it a secret. Let's keep it a secret. Let's complain that we can't get anybody here, but let's not do anything about it. I'm saying that BPAC and the group that's in it needs some help. But if somebody from REC would like to work with us, we can start putting together packages of channels and packages of things like that and talk about, you know, Lazy Ride and Island Glow. Island Glow is a beautiful thing. The Christmas event, all of the other small communities promote that, Chesaning and Frankenmuth. We can do it just as good as them. But nobody knows we're doing it. How about it, committee? Can we get some combined commission support to do this?
Absolutely.
Would there be somebody in this committee that would like to step up and work with them?
Yes.
Mr. Conroy.
Got it. Jane Fijel and Bob Firmstone are the two people from our committee. One or two from yours would be great. Let's go after it. It doesn't cost anything. They said the only thing that you can't put in there is religious or political. You know, so I'm going to have to tell Jane she's going to take the Knights of Columbus out of the center of hers. But other than that, we really promote. You know, here she's got it in here. And she's kind of one-man band, I'll tell you that. And she's a real firecracker. You give her your thoughts and she'll put together things for you if you don't have them already. But I'm going to tell Bob to get a hold of you.
Already talked to him.
Oh, okay. that's the reason I was here. By the way, how do you like the bike pass? And the bridges, aren't they looking sharp?
Yeah they are. Yeah.
Looking great.
All I have, guys. Like I said, stretch your stuff. You do good work.
Thank you, Waller. Dale?
Good evening, everyone. Dale Riem, Township Manager. I am here this evening. I was here for a couple committee meetings prior to this commission meeting, and Chairman Ketcher told me I had to stay. He wouldn't let me go home. so I wanted to update you on those items. But a comment was made earlier about the absence of Trustee Malvesto. And I just want to go on record. Trustee Malvesto was scheduled out of town. And he sent myself, the supervisor, and Brandy an email just yesterday that he's going to be gone this meeting and also miss the next board meeting. So there was a notification to us. The first committee meeting I attended this evening was the rink subcommittee. We're getting ready for the upcoming season. And we unfortunately were in the process of planning a fundraiser for this fall, but it fell through to unforeseen circumstances. But we do have a date, June 25th of 2016, for a golf outing. Stay tuned for details. It will be a very exciting event. And we're also looking at possibly doing some other things midwinter. Brandy is working with Carl and the group of volunteers coordinating their schedules for this upcoming winter in the rink schedule and the rink use. So obviously it's all weather dependent. So that's all in process. And the last item was the AED meeting. And I don't know, Natalie, do you care to touch on those items a little bit and what that project involved? It's something that we've been working on with the police chief and the fire chief.
I don't really have anything now.
We're working on it. Okay.
Got it.
Just an overall thing of what you want to do, maybe.
Is the commission aware of this project?
I know. I don't believe so. Tom did bring it up about the need for it, but yes. We don't know where we're at.
Yes. Yes. Okay. So what we had done, we previously met with the police chief, the fire chief, Trustee Mavesto, Brandy, Mr. Snyder, Ms. Snyder, myself, and we're in the process of doing an inventory of the community. What facilities, what locations would make sense to have this AED device, which is the automatic electronic defibrillator. Is that the correct? Okay. I want to make sure I got my acronym. To decide where does it make sense to have these, work with the community groups to determine whether or not they want to, when they're at the sporting events, at the fields, to actually carry these items with them, or what other possibilities are there. So we're evaluating what we have, where it would make sense to deploy them. There's one in this building, for instance. There's one in the recreation building. They're in some of the police cars, but not all. So that's the type of thing we're looking into to see how can we better serve the community. So that's the gist of the project, and we're going to try to determine what we have, is this good, or are there additional deployments in different ways or different items we can treat to bring the service to people? And are there other trainings and other types of activities we could take to do outreach? So that's the gist of the project, which is being led by Mr. Snyder and Ms. Snyder.
Thank you. Any questions, Dale, about the AEDs, the skating rink?
I have a question.
Ann.
Is there one here in this building, Dale?
Yes, right by the elevator.
All town buildings have them in them.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Anything else? Thank you.
All right. Well, thank you very much for your time.
Dale?
You're welcome. Thanks
for keeping me, Chairman Kerr.
You're welcome. Lisa wanted me to make sure you're here. Tom, you got something to add?
Tom Snyder, still 8448 Rucker. Brandy, I know you talked a little bit about the golf course, but how successful was the foot golf for the year?
I brought numbers with me.
Awesome.
It was definitely successful for us. We had over 300 rounds. We had two parties that chose foot golf as their party. They scheduled with us. We had a 24-person league out there this summer. And then we did a coupon when the soccer players were doing Island Fest. They had the Island Cup tournament, and we handed out coupons, and we took in 20 of them. So that was $100 right there that we got from that advertising. Just normal off-the-street people came in. 278 golf, and then an additional 20 with a coupon. We had there's 23 people in the league. So that was about $1,800 that we brought in. So overall, we brought in over $5,000, which was definitely more than what we paid for the equipment.
So the way I'm understanding, the way you're explaining to me, next year we shouldn't have to buy too much equipment. I think we did a good job of purchasing that, so everything at that point in time should be a profit?
Yep. Any equipment, we do have to replace the lids because those were burned in the fire.
Okay.
So those have to be replaced. The only other thing is if we wanted to purchase additional holes,
or if sometimes we have damage to the flags or anything, but the initial equipment, it's purchased. So yeah, anything pretty much from July on is all extra income. We've covered our costs.
Awesome. I'm sure everybody in the island appreciates you bringing that idea here to make sure that we're able to do that. I'd like to just piggyback on to what our township manager had said. Both Natalie and I have a strong belief by the AED machine. So we are not only working with different departments with inside Grocio, but with also the different organizations in order to make this safer. Both of us have a belief that we can, not that we didn't do a good job before, but we thought we can do a better job. And once we get towards the end, I'm sure we'll make a presentation to the Community Recreation Commission, make sure everybody's updated and explain what we did, why we did, where we go from here. So I just want to make sure you guys know that we will update you as we get closer to the end, but we're not quite there yet.
All right.
So thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thanks, Tom.
All right. Individual commissioner comments. Mike, anything to add?
I just wanted to thank Grosseal Township Trustee Walt Boziak for joining our meeting tonight, and also Township Manager Dale Ryumi. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Helena, anything to add?
Where'd we get these?
From our Township Manager.
Thank you. That's all. Thank you. Are they from you?
Actually, downstairs. They're from the it's more part of the watershed group.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, he want more, don't you?
I have no comments. I just want to know.
Ethel, anything to add?
A couple things. The Island Artists Exhibits, this is your last chance to go and see them this weekend at the Grosseal Historical Society Customs House. Saturday and Sunday from 1 to 4 p.m., and they're very excellent exhibits of what island people can do with arts, and it's not just pictures. They've done rugs and quilts and lots of things for you to see. And Brandy did bring up about the Hawaiian Halloween costume parade. And then on Wednesday, October the 28th, they have the Glow Roll 3 Bikers with Lights. They meet at Sharky's at Water's Edge at 7 p.m., two routes of 7.8 miles and 10.9 miles, and they'll have cider and donuts by the Grosseal Rotary Club prior to the ride, and contact is tour, T-O-U-R-D-E-I-L-E at gmail.com. It sounds like fun.
All right. Greg, anything to add?
Nothing at this time.
Ann, anything to add?
I just wanted to wish everybody a happy Halloween. That's coming up. And we'll see you next month.
John, anything to add?
And happy Halloween as well. We have a big record show happening at Henry Ford College Saturday from 10 a.m., I'm sorry, till 4. Thousands of records, CDs, videos, and other music memorabilia. For sale by independent, local, and out-of-state vendors, and it's only $5 to get in. Amazing array. Lots of food, lots of other activities as well. Come join us.
All right. Natalie, anything to add?
Bottle Can Drive this Saturday, please. if you can't get your cans up, find a way to contact me. I will get them from you somehow. Every little bit helps, I promise.
All right. Brandy, anything to add?
Just again, the Halloween parade is this Saturday. Lineup starts at 9:15. The parade begins at 10:15. Parade. I was like, that's not sounding right. Parade starts at 10:30, and we'll march down McCone Street, and then everyone gets to go trick or treating in the downtown area. And then just, you know, if you don't have your channels anymore, it is online. There's a flip through version where you can flip through the magazine virtually online. We have Island Glow coming up in December. I believe it's December 5th. And then that Saturday after Island Glow, we have Dinner with Santa, which is new this year. We've always had a brunch, and we're trying some new things. So I encourage people to look through the brochure, looking at our upcoming events and special events, and register early for them.
Cool. Thanks. All right. So any of your notes you have, please give it to Brandy before you leave. Motion to adjourn, please.
So moved.
John, second.
I'll second.
And all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion to adjourn has been approved. Please volunteer community and have a good night. Thank you.